Now is the entrance of the recipients of today's awards. Shall we welcome the recipients? Keep the applause coming. We've done well so far. I know it's a test of endurance, but it is appreciated. It is now my pleasure to announce the arrival of the Prime Minister of Saint Lucia, the Honorable Philippe J. Pierre, and Miss Marie Felix. If you may just indulge me for a moment here, I'll just kindly ask us to ensure that our mobile devices are either on vibrate or silent or off if possible. Thank you. Shall we all stand to receive the Prime Minister of Saint Lucia and Miss Marie Felix? And shall we remain standing as we receive the Acting Governor General, Mr. Errol Charles, and Mrs. Anicia Charles. Shall we all stand at attention as the Royal Saint Lucia Police Band renders the national anthem? Kindly remain standing as we invite Reverend Father Ignatius Dominic Setut for the invocation. Shall we all assume a posture for prayer?
In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and under the protection of His Most Immaculate Mother, Mary, Ever Virgin, we praise you, Eternal Father, in union with the Holy Spirit, from the rising of the sun to the going down. In this year of our Lord Jesus Christ, 2024, we thank and praise you for our 45th anniversary of independence from the United Kingdom. May you bless and protect our land, St. Lucia, the full length of 26 miles and the full width of 14 miles. Bless this esteemed ceremony here today, especially the recipients of awards, their families, and their households. May we all aspire towards a profound spiritual life, resilience, creativity, togetherness, patriotism, and love for the common good. May we, in this land, St. Lucia, who bear the name Lucy, benefit from her profound intercession from generation to generation, in all age groups, professions, employments, churches, schools, and everyone from all walks of life. We make this prayer with a sure faith, coming from the depths of our hearts, as we aspire to remain in communion with you, O Eternal Father, in union with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you very much, Reverend Dominic Seytoot. May we all take our seats. Thank you. Their Excellencies, Acting Governor General, and Mrs. Anicia Charles, Honorable Prime Minister Philip J. Pierre and Miss Mary Felix, President of the Senate, Honorable Alvina Reynolds, Speaker of the House of Assembly, Honorable Claudius Francis, Monsignor Patrick Anthony, Your Excellency Dame Prelate Louise, Governor General Emerita, former Prime Minister Dr. Vaughan Lewis and Lady Lewis, Cabinet Ministers and Members of Parliament, Ambassadors and High Commissioners of Saint Lucia and Members of the Diplomatic Corps, Holders of Saint Lucia Cross, Cabinet Secretary Mr. Augusto Degaso and Spouse, Permanent Secretaries, Commissioner of Police, Heads of Public Services and Commissions, Mayors, Fellow Members of the National Awards Committee, recipients of the 2024 Independence Awards and their guests, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I bid you the heartiest of greetings on this fine Sunday afternoon. How appropriate it is that we gather at this magnificent compound, an edifice that is well elevated, overseeing the city of Castries. In some way, this geographical setting, by way of its altitude above sea level, is analogous to the heightened dimension of achievements of our distinguished awardees. They have demonstrated absolute excellence in their various disciplines and fields of endeavor, now meriting the conferring of the Order of St. Lucia and Public Services Long Services Awards. We are reminded that these outstanding sons and daughters of this land have achieved, what they have achieved has not only brought personal edification and advancement, but most importantly, their monumental efforts over the years have served to develop our nation immeasurably. And I think it would be very appropriate to give them a round of applause at this time. So as we proceed with the program, as stated, I'll now like to invite to the podium Mrs. Mauricio Thomas Francis, the Chair of the National Awards Committee, to deliver the official welcome remarks. Shall we welcome Mrs. Francis?
Thank you very much, Master of Ceremonies. The Excellencies Acting Governor General and Mrs. Anicia Charles, Honorable Prime Minister Felix J. Pierre and Miss Mary Felix, President of the Senate, Honorable Alvina Reynolds, Speaker of the House of Assembly, Honorable Claudius Francis, Monsignor Patrick Anthony, Your Excellency, Dame Paulette Louise, Governor General Emerita, former Prime Minister Dr. Vaughan Lewis and Mrs. Lewis, Cabinet Ministers and Members of Parliament, Ambassadors and High Commissioners to St. Lucia, and members of the Diplomatic Corps, holders of St. Lucia Cross, Cabinet Secretary Mr. Augusto Degaso and spouse, Permanent Secretaries, Commissioner of Police, Heads of Public Services and Commissions, Mayors, Father Dominic Seytoot, fellow members of the National Awards Committee, investiture recipients, specially invited guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It is profoundly heartwarming, a distinct honor and special privilege to to once again deliver the welcome remarks on such an auspicious occasion. We are gathered here today at this most salubrious setting because 40 patriotic Saint Lucian men and women conscientiously chose to go above and beyond. Their determination defeated the doubt that loomed over their dreams and aspirations. Their perseverance outpaced their failures. Each of our honorees imbues the essence of resilience and purpose. Many of them chose country over self. Some chose bravery to believe in themselves. That belief has led all of them to the eternal pages of our country's evolving history, and all of you gather here to witness history being written in real time. The world watched when Darren Sammy twice collected the coveted trophy for winning the men's ICC T20 tournament. All eyes were on Julian Alfred when she became the first Saint Lucian to win a gold medal at the just concluded World Athletics Indoor Championship. The literary world came to a standstill when the Nobel Prize for Literature was conferred on the late Sir Derek Walcott. This list is not exhaustive. But how many witnessed their setbacks and struggles? How many cheered them on during the tireless hours in practice, whether on the track, on the pitch, or in the studio, laboring away, honing their skills to be the best at what they do? It is time for this part of the history to be told. Sir Derek Walcott once remarked, and I quote, "Any serious attempt to try to do something worthwhile is ritualistic," unquote. Like the Darren Sammy and Julian Alfreds and Guy Ellis's and Kendall Hippolytes and Ronald Boohinson of the day, the 40 sons and daughters before us embody the fruitful formula of ritualistic effort. You all have demonstrated that rituals, commitment, compassion, excellence, and selflessness build character and produce results. Your prodigious efforts behind the desk, in the line of duty, on stage, and in the community propelled you to summit of your disciplines while advancing the development of our beloved country. Permit me leave to borrow a proposition from Confucius, and I quote, "Study the past if you would define the future," unquote. Ladies and gentlemen, the pages of investiture turn back nearly 40 years. Indeed, investiture is a repository of case studies. Is it not time to open the annals of investiture to study the honorees, follow the stories, and learn how they defied the odds and overcame? Yes, it is a good time. Time that will be well spent. Can the study of this part of our past be used to define a future society propagated with the ideals and values intrinsic to our past and present investiture recipients? We need not look further than in our midst, as we are among walking, living, and breathing investiture case studies. It is time to make use of our experiences, consume their accounts. The stories of the triumphs can spark the flame of inspiration to illuminate your pathway towards personal success. As chair of the National Awards Committee, I say to you unreservedly that it is my pleasure to be in your presence and to extend warmest welcome to you all. I also wish to extend my special thanks to all the citizens who have all citizens here, and in the diaspora who have taken the time out to submit nominations. The members of the National Awards Committee will not be overlooked. I am tremendously pleased to report that their selfless efforts and dutiful administration of the nomination process sustain the high standards we set for ourselves as a committee. Ours is a task that demands meticulous analysis and the ability to provide responsive and useful support to the public. The committee that I am proudly chair of exemplified these qualities this year and over the past years. I invite members present to stand to be suitably recognized. Members of my committee, thank you. Just for the benefit of you, ladies and gentlemen, the committee, we have a 7-member committee. We have representation of the leader of the opposition, representation of the government. We have an independent representative who, in the person of Mr. Wilbert King, who unfortunately couldn't be here today. Chairman of the Public Service Commission, and also we have Madam Secretary, and of course yours truly. Give them another round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Cooperation with our stakeholders, the Independence Committee, Government House, and Events Company of St. Lucia was seamless. The support from the Government of St. Lucia, in particular the Office of the Prime Minister, to stage this illustrious celebration continues to exceed expectations. Job well done to the individuals involved in the Investiture 2024. Congratulations to each of our honorees today. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Investiture 2024. I thank you profoundly.
Remarks very well received by the chair of the awards committee for the Investiture for 2024. And as I listened attentively to Mrs. Thomas Francis saying that history has been written in real time, I'm not sure if we are aware that on this day, today being the 17th of March in 1992, apartheid was abolished in South Africa. And this is rather interesting that we gather today on this date to celebrate our luminaries, sons and daughters of St. Lucia, and even more so as we have a theme that speaks to a unity, which is quite opposite to apartheid, a theme for our independence, devoir ensemble, building a nation through unity, resilience, and creativity. This embraces diversity. So this is truly a very special occasion, very special occasion. At this time, I just want to invite you to ensure that you enjoy the moment. I know that we are all formally attired and well accessorized, but we need to feel relaxed because this is a celebration. Allow me now to introduce to you our orators for this afternoon ceremony. First orator, we have Mrs. Natalie Jolie Fannis, and we also have Ms. Kiba Tilliam. So we acknowledge their presence. And at this time, it is my pleasure to invite His Excellency, the Governor, Acting Governor General, Mr. Errol Childs, and a private secretary to the stage for the commencement of the investiture.
The St. Lucia Cross, Anthony Brian Severin. For distinguished service in the field of government, public service, foreign service, and the diplomatic corps. Anthony Severin a distinguished figure in St. Lucia's public service, has dedicated over four decades of his life to the betterment of his country. His achievements span across various fields, showcasing excellence and unwavering commitment. Currently serving as St. Lucia's High Commissioner to the United Kingdom, Ambassador to France, and a permanent representative to several organizations, including the World Trade Organization and the Commonwealth Secretariat, Severin's diplomatic competence has significantly elevated his country's stature on the global stage. Severin's career in public service includes serving in top positions within the St. Lucia Public Service and the Organization of Eastern Caribbean States, OECS. He held roles such as Cabinet Secretary, Permanent Secretary, and Head of International Relations, demonstrating his versatility and capability to navigate complex governmental structures. His contributions extend beyond administrative roles. Severin has been instrumental in shaping policies related to macroeconomics, trade, tourism, national security, and disaster management. His adept handling of St. Lucia's campaign for membership of the United Nations Economic and Social Council and piloting the country's offers in multilateral trade negotiations underscore his strategic vision and diplomatic finesse. Severin's diplomatic career includes serving as Ambassador Extraordinaire and Plenipotentiary to CARICOM and the United Nations. As the first person appointed to these positions, he played a pivotal role in defining their scope and enhancing engagement between St. Lucia and regional and international bodies. His leadership as permanent representative to the United Nations saw him chairing significant bodies such as the Special Committee on Decolonization and the Alliance of Small Island States. He led United Nations missions and represented St. Lucia at various international summits, amplifying the country's voice on critical issues. Severin's contributions to the OECS have been equally impactful as head of international relations. Under his guidance, the organization strengthened diplomatic ties with numerous countries and expanded its reach across continents. His efforts led to the establishment of joint diplomatic missions and the accession of French Caribbean regions to associate membership in the OECS. Beyond his professional endeavors, Severin's interest in social and cultural spheres include preserving St. Lucia's folk heritage to contributing to archaeological and historical societies. Anthony Severin's illustrious career epitomizes dedication, leadership, and service to St. Lucia. His achievements in diplomacy, public administration, and cultural preservation have not only elevated his nation's profile, but also inspired future generations to strive for excellence in service to their country. For distinguished service in the field of government, public service, foreign service, and diplomatic corps, the St. Lucia Cross is presented to Mr. Anthony Brian Severin. The St. Lucia Medal of Honor, Gold. Fernanda Maria Henry, for eminent service rendered in the field of forensic sciences. Fernanda Fernando Henry, as the director of the Forensic Sciences Laboratory, has shown exceptional leadership by steering the laboratory from adversity to accreditation, making it the first accredited forensic facility in the Eastern Caribbean and second in CARICOM. This achievement is not merely a professional milestone, but a regional triumph vital for addressing the high rates of violent crimes, including sexual assaults. Upon assuming leadership in 2016, Henry faced significant challenges, including a drastic reduction in staff and the laboratory's closure due to evidence impropriety issues. With determination, the lab reopened in 2017 under her resolute guidance. Even during the COVID-19 pandemic, she volunteered the lab to provide PCR testing training, showcasing stability and reliability in crisis situations. Moreover, Henry has played a crucial role in fostering collaboration within the Caribbean medical legal movement, organizing symposia and introducing peer-reviewed mechanisms to ensure quality control, a pioneering effort in the region. Collaborating with renowned forensic pathologist Dr. Alfredo Walker, she initiated expert witness training, demonstrating her commitment to excellence and professional development. Her leadership extends beyond the laboratory, influencing the development of forensic science in the criminal justice system, as acknowledged by a High Court judge. Through her vision, humility, and compassion, Fernando Henry has not only transformed the Forensic Sciences Laboratory, but also uplifted the region's capabilities in forensic sciences, leaving a lasting impact on both national and regional levels. For eminent service rendered in the field of forensic sciences, Miss Fernanda Maria Henry is awarded the Saint Lucia Medal of Honor Gold. Trevor Martin Luisi, for eminent service rendered in the field of national development, the energy sector, and community service. Trevor Luisi's tenure at St. Lucia Electricity Services Limited, LUCELEC, spans over 36 years, from trainee engineer in 1986 to managing director from 2004 to June 2023. Luisi has held various positions within the company, showcasing his dedication and leadership in the energy sector. Under his guidance, LUCELEC experienced significant growth and expansion, navigating challenges with resilience and strategic planning. His visionary leadership led to the development of strategic business plans that positioned the company and St. Lucia at the forefront of the energy sector regionally and internationally. Notable achievements during Luis's tenure include the planning and commissioning of the cul-de-sac power station and the 66-kV transmission system. He spearheaded extensive electrification programs in rural communities and the installation of streetlights along major highways, transforming the country's infrastructure and boosting economic development. A significant milestone under Luisi's leadership was the commissioning of St. Lucia's first solar farm in 2018, making a shift towards renewable energy initiatives. This endeavor received praise from former U.S. President Bill Clinton, highlighting its potential to make St. Lucia and other Caribbean nations more sustainable. Beyond infrastructure development, Luisi demonstrated a commitment to customer satisfaction and community welfare. He ensured immediate amendments to policies hindering customer satisfaction, provided swift responses to queries, and remained available during natural disasters to restore power promptly. Under his stewardship, Lucilec became a benchmark for utility operations, social and economic development, earning respect locally and regionally. Luis's dedication to corporate social responsibility is evident through his involvement in various boards and community initiatives impacting St. Lucia's welfare on economic and social levels. Through Luis's leadership, St. Lucia has emerged as an innovator in the energy sector, paving the way for sustainable growth and development. His legacy embodies the power of caring, driving positive change and transformation in the country's energy and social landscape. For eminent service rendered in the field of national development in the energy sector and for community service, Trevor Martin Luisi is awarded the Saint Lucia Medal of Honor Gold. Round of applause, ladies, once again. Monsignor Michael Michelle Francis, for eminent service rendered in the field of liturgy and community service. Father Michelle Francis has demonstrated exceptional leadership and commitment through his extensive career in the Archdiocese of Castries. Notably, he served as Vicar General under two different archbishops, Archbishop Robert Rivas and Archbishop Gabriel Malzer, showcasing his trusted leadership within the church hierarchy. His roles as parish priest at St. Joseph the Worker Parish in Groseley and cathedral administrator in Castries highlight his dedication to pastoral care and administrative duties within the church. Father Francis's involvement in various councils and commissions, including the Presbytery Council and the Board of Directors of the Cardinal Felix Archdiocesan Pastoral Center, underscores his active participation in the decision-making processes of the Archdiocese. Furthermore, his educational background in theology and liturgy, coupled with his role as a lecturer at the Permanent Diaconate Program and the Pre-Seminary in St. Lucia, demonstrates his commitment to the intellectual and spiritual formation of future clergy. Outside of his ecclesiastical duties, Father Francis has also contributed significantly to civic life, serving on various boards and commissions aimed at shaping national policies and addressing community needs, reflecting his broader commitment to social justice and community service. For eminent service rendered in the field of liturgy and community service, Monsignor Michael Michelle Francis is awarded the Saint Lucia Medal of Honor Gold.
The St. Lucia Medal of Honor, Silver, Dominic Prosper, for eminent service rendered in the field of community and youth development. Dominic Prosper is a distinguished educator and community leader in St. Lucia. With a career spanning over four decades, he has made significant contributions to both education and community development. Beginning as a teacher in 1978, Prosper rose through the ranks, eventually serving as acting department head, vice principal, and principal at the Soufre Comprehensive Secondary School. He holds advanced certifications in educational management and a master's in business administration, specializing in educational administration. Outside of the classroom, Prosper has been instrumental in community initiatives. He founded youth organizations, facilitated the establishment of preschools and daycare centers, and provided free evening classes in mathematics. He played a pivotal role in disaster response efforts, formed development committees, and led various community groups and associations. Prosper's selfless dedication has garnered recognition, including awards from the Ministry of Community Development and the Caribbean Association of Secondary School Principals. He remains actively involved in community work, exemplifying a lifelong commitment to service and mentorship. For eminent service rendered in the field of community and youth development, Dominic Prosper is awarded the St. Lucia Medal of Honor Silver. Anthony Bellas, for eminent service rendered in the field of agriculture and community service. Anthony Bellas, JP, has left an indelible mark on both the agricultural sector and community development in St. Lucia. Beginning his career as an agricultural extension officer in 1974, Bellas quickly became known for his hands-on approach and excellent rapport with farmers. He later ventured into entrepreneurship, establishing the Auger Poultry Farm and pioneering the importation of plastic water tanks in the South. Bellas's commitment to community service is equally commendable. He has been actively involved in various church, sport, and social associations, including disaster relief efforts, church leadership roles, and youth development initiatives. As Vice President of the Southern Particular Council of St. Vincent de Paul Charity, he has earned the title Champion of the Poor for his dedication to helping the needy. Recognized for his outstanding contributions, Bellas was appointed a Justice of the Peace in 1997. His guidance and counseling services are highly valued, reflecting his status as a senior citizen of great merit in St. Lucian society. Through his multifaceted endeavors, Anthony Bellas has exemplified a lifelong commitment to service and community betterment. For eminent service rendered in the field of agriculture and community service, Anthony Bellas is awarded the St. Lucia Medal of Honor Silver. Brenda Sifley Morissette, for eminent service rendered in the field of public service. Brenda Sifley Morissette dedicated 30 years to the St. Lucian public service, leaving a profound impact through her strategic initiatives and dedicated service. Starting in 1985 at the Accountant General's Department, she modernized financial reporting, paving the way for efficient debt management with the establishment of the Debt Recording and Management Unit. Transitioning to the Ministry of Education in 1999, she played a significant role in restructuring financial systems amidst sweeping educational reforms. Her tenure at the Ministry of Justice saw her overseeing the establishment of critical units contributing to the growth of the ministry. Returning to the Accountant General's Department in 2009, she spearheaded transformative projects such as cash management and migration to new international accounting standards. Known for her commitment and passion for excellence, Sifley Morissette's tireless efforts and strategic vision significantly contributed to the efficiency and effectiveness of the public sector in St. Lucia. For eminent service rendered in the field of public service, Brenda Sifley Morissette is awarded the St. Lucia Medal of Honor Silver. Thank you.
the Saint Lucia Medal of Merit Gold, Raymond Michael Gustav, for long and meritorious service in the field of community and national development, entrepreneurship, philanthropy, and tourism. Raymond Michael Gustav has made significant and lasting contributions to community development, national development, and entrepreneurship over the span of 34 years. As a dedicated community leader, he co-founded the Sufra Development Program and at the young age of 21, aiming to uplift his community. Under his leadership, the SDP transformed Sulphur Springs into a tourist attraction and developed essential infrastructure for Sufra's economic growth. His commitment to community welfare led him to serve on various boards and councils, including the Sufra Regional Development Foundation, SRDF, where he played a pivotal role in securing funding for tourism projects and marine conservation efforts. In the realm of entrepreneurship, Michael's innovative ventures have reshaped Sufra's tourism landscape. As the owner of M&A Sightseeing Tours, he facilitated the transportation of over 800,000 visitors and indirectly employed dozens of locals. Additionally, he invested in Villa de Pitor, Sufra's first locally owned boutique resort, and spearheaded the development of a waterfront dining complex. Beyond his business endeavors, Michael is known for his philanthropy, supporting education, sports, and community events. His unwavering dedication to the betterment of Sufra and Saint Lucia is deserving of national recognition. For long and meritorious service in the field of community and national development, entrepreneurship, philanthropy, and tourism, Raymond Michael Gustav is awarded the Saint Lucia Medal of Merit Gold. Nicholas Jean-Baptiste, for long and meritorious service in the field of law, community, and youth development, sports, and agriculture. Nicholas Jean-Baptiste stands as a beacon of service and dedication in Monrepo and St. Lucia, contributing across various domains for over four decades. As a legal expert, he selflessly offers his knowledge for the betterment of his community. His role as General Secretary of the Monrepo Youth and Sports Council underscores his commitment to community activism, organizing cultural and sporting events while nurturing youth development. Jean-Baptiste's impact also extends to sports development, notably through initiatives like the annual Independence Road Relay and the annual raffle. He leverages technology, managing online platforms for community engagement and information dissemination. Jean-Baptiste's legal legacy includes roles in sporting associations, agricultural contributions, and public service engagements. His unwavering dedication to community welfare and environmental conservation makes him a deserving candidate for national recognition of his outstanding service to St. Lucia. For long and meritorious service in the field of law, community and youth development, sports and agriculture, Nicholas Jean-Baptiste is awarded the Saint Lucia Medal of Merit Gold. Allison Talius Markey, for long and meritorious service in the field of arts, music.
Did I get that right? Talia?
Allison Markey is a stalwart in the steel pan community, beginning his journey at 13 with the Babono Superstars Steel Orchestra and swiftly advancing to arranging for the band by age 15. His co-arrangement for the National Panorama Competition in 1980 marked the start of his illustrious career. Co-founding the Courts Babono Steel Orchestra in 2000, in 2007, Markey led the band to multiple Panorama Championships, 2011, 2012, 2017, 2018, 2019, and 2022, showcasing his arranging prowess. His influence extends beyond performance, as he has taught countless youngsters the art of pan playing and conducted workshops for the Cultural Development Foundation. Markey's musical versatility extends to big band formats and collaborations with renowned artists and bands, including the Royal Saint Lucia Police Band and prominent Calypsonians. His compositions and performances have graced international stages like the Barbados and Guadeloupe Jazz Festivals. A perpetual student of music, Markey continues to innovate and inspire, leaving an indelible mark on the steel pan world and his native Saint Lucia. His dedication to sharing his expertise through arranging classes underscores his commitment to nurturing musical talent and enriching cultural heritage. For long and meritorious service in the field of the arts, music, Alison Talias Markey is awarded the Saint Lucia Medal of Merit Gold. The Saint Lucia Medal of Merit Silver, Mildred Joseph, for long and meritorious service in the field of community service, caregiver. Round of applause. Miss Mildred Joseph's journey is defined by her unwavering dedication to serving others, particularly the elderly, and her commitment to community development. From her early days at the Ave Maria Girls Primary School to her later studies at the Girls Vocational School, her passion for elderly care was evident. Joining the Duke of Edinburgh Group, she dedicated herself to caring for the needy and sick, volunteering at the Marion Home. Throughout her career, Ms. Joseph's compassion and resourcefulness shone brightly. Rising through various roles, she volunteered extensively at institutions like the OKEU Hospital and Wellness Center, enriching the lives of countless individuals. Her efforts extended beyond borders, sourcing essential items for those in need. With certification as a community health aide, Ms. Joseph became supervisor for the Caregivers Program in Babunu. Her leadership extends to her roles as president of the Plateau Red Cross and women coordinator at the Seventh-day Adventist Church. A role model in Babunu, she uplifts and motivates young people while brightening the lives of the elderly through outings and companionship. Ms. Joseph's exceptional character and dedication to community service make her a deserving candidate for recognition. For long and meritorious service in the field of community service, caregiver, Mildred Joseph is awarded the Saint Lucia Medal of Merit Silver. Modest Downs, for long and meritorious service in the field of arts, music, poetry, journalism, community, and social development. Modest Downs has left an indelible mark on Saint Lucia through his contributions to education, journalism, politics, trade union activism, and community development. Downs pursued a diverse educational path, including studies in philosophy, French, and development studies. Throughout his career, Downs has demonstrated exceptional dedication and talent. As an educator, he imparted knowledge at various schools, including the Viewfort Boys School and the Viewfort Junior Secondary School. He also served as an administrator and project officer for the Roman Catholic Church, contributing to community outreach programs. Downs made significant strides in journalism, founding the Lucian newspaper and contributing as a columnist and reporter for various media outlets. His literary prowess is evident in his published works, including poetry collections such as Phases and Theater of the Mind, which have earned him prestigious awards and accolades. Additionally, Downs has been actively involved in social and community development initiatives, co-founding the Southern Calypso Association and organizing relief efforts after Hurricane Alain. His commitment to uplifting the community has earned him recognition from organizations like the National Youth Council and the Cultural Development Foundation. Modest Downs' contributions to literature, culture, and community development exemplify the spirit of service and excellence deserving of recognition. For long and meritorious service in the field of arts, music, poetry, journalism, community, and social development, Modest Downs is a awarded the Saint Lucia Medal of Merit Silver. Ernest Auger, for long and meritorious service in the field of community service. Mr. Ernest Auger stands as a beacon of exemplary and long-standing service to the community of Soufrière, Saint Lucia, embodying decades of dedication and commitment across various spheres of community development. Rooted in his humble beginnings on High Street, Mr. Auger's journey to his current role leading the Soufrière Regional Development Foundation epitomizes the spirit of community empowerment and transformation. Throughout his career, Mr. Auger held key leadership positions, including chairman of the Soufrière Town Council, demonstrating adeptness in governance and community administration. His resilience shone brightly as coordinator of the Hurricane Rehabilitation Program post-Hurricane Allen, showcasing commitment to community restoration. Mr. Auger's involvement in sports organizations nurtured a culture of sportsmanship and provided youth with enriching opportunities. Education remained paramount in his journey, reflected in his academic pursuits and subsequent contributions as General Secretary of the St. Lucia Teachers Union. His versatile work history, from teaching to corporate leadership, underscores his adaptability and acumen. At the Soufrière Regional Development Foundation, he spearheaded transformative initiatives, including the strategic planning exercise Soufrière 2040, shaping the community's future. In the face of adversity like the COVID-19 pandemic, Mr. Auger revived cultural events, revitalizing community spirit and economic activity. His unwavering dedication to Soufrière's holistic development merits recognition, making him a deserving candidate for the St. Lucia Medal of Merit in Community Service. For long and meritorious service in the field of community service, Mr. Ernest Auger is awarded the St. Lucia Medal of Merit Silver.
As I listen to the citations, I can't help but say that it's truly inspiring what we have heard so far from our fellow sons and daughters of St. Lucia. And I truly hope that we can take something from this as we leave this place later on and go to our families as we meet the children of the communities, and hoping that everyone who is viewing on our local networks and the World Wide Web will also be truly inspired by what we have heard so far. Please allow me to extend apologies on behalf of the chair of the awards committee for just failing to mention that the commissioner of police, Mrs. Cruetta Descartes-Pelius, is also a member of the awards committee, and her contributions have been invaluable. So we acknowledge her as well. So it is timely that we have a bit of a deviation from what we're doing, just to reset. And I'd like to invite the world-renowned, I dare say, world-renowned Barbara Kaday to render performance.
Oh,
Absolutely magnificent. Didn't expect anything less from Barbara Kadee. Can we give her another round of applause, please? Perhaps this is getting us ready for the St. Lucia Jazz and Arts Festival, yeah? Just a little plug in there. As I look around the audience, I notice that we are punctuated with some greens. And today, the 17th of March, is also St. Patrick's Day. Perhaps this is why Fernanda has such a lovely green dress. So allow me now to call back to the podium Miss Kiba Tilliam, who will continue with the citations. Okay, it's going to be Natalie, my apologies.
The St. Lucia Lepitor Medal Gold, Alton Laurie Crafton. For having performed a long and meritorious service in the field of sports and youth development. Alton Laurie Crafton epitomizes dedication and excellence in cricket, deserving of national recognition for his enduring service to the sport. Starting his journey at St. Mary's College, Crafton's passion for cricket flourished as he represented both St. Lucia and the Windward Islands. Transitioning from player to coach, Crafton dedicated himself to nurturing young talent, particularly from underprivileged backgrounds, molding them into successful cricketers. Crafton's coaching skills have left an indelible mark on St. Lucian cricket. He has coached various national and regional teams, demonstrating unmatched patience, commitment, and genuine care for the well-being of his players. Despite facing challenges such as limited funding and lack of recognition, Crafton's resilience and determination have prevailed. As head coach of the Northern Cluster Grassroots Cricket Program, Crafton has transformed the lives of over 130 boys and girls, providing them with opportunities to fulfill their cricketing dreams. His success stories include grooming talents like Kimani Melius, McKinney Clark, and Kiana Joseph, who have gone on to represent the West Indies cricket at various levels. Crafton's selfless dedication, coupled with his remarkable achievements in cricket coaching and mentorship, make him a true sporting hero deserving of national honor and acclaim. For having performed a long and meritorious service in the field of sports and youth development, Alton Laurie Crafton is being awarded the St. Lucia Lepitor Medal Gold. Marinus Albert Pascal. For having performed a long and meritorious service in the field of community, social, and youth development. Marinus Albert Pascal stands as a beacon of selflessness and dedication, with a lifelong commitment to serving others. Marinus exemplifies servant leadership, prioritizing the needs of the community above his own. As a devoted father and husband, he sets an admirable standard of familial devotion. Throughout his career, Marinus has tirelessly championed the cause of youth and the less fortunate, serving as a mentor, advocate, and friend to countless young individuals. From his early days as a laboratory technician to his roles in community development and poverty reduction, Marinus has consistently worked towards uplifting marginalized communities and addressing societal issues. His tenure in various civil service roles reflects a steadfast dedication to serving the people of St. Lucia. Notably, Marinus played an instrumental role in coordinating the relocation of residents affected by the Black Mali landslide, demonstrating compassion and leadership in the face of adversity. Beyond his professional achievements, Marinus's volunteer work with organizations like the Interschool and College Christian Fellowship, ISCCF, and Gideon's International underscores his unwavering commitment to community service and spiritual upliftment. Marinus's attributes of patience, humility, and tireless work ethic have left an indelible mark on all who have had the privilege of knowing him. His profound impact on youth development and community resilience makes him a true unsung hero deserving of national recognition. For having performed long and meritorious service in the field of community, social, and youth development, Marinus Albert Pascal is being awarded the Saint Lucia Lepitor Medal Gold. Pastor Dr. Andrew Leons. For having performed long and meritorious service in the field of community service. Dr. Andrew Leos's career as a probation officer in the 1980s saw him managing offices in Castries, Miku, and Denry, where he intervened in numerous families' lives, grappling with issues like domestic violence and economic constraints. His commitment to the community transcended his official duties as he personally funded initiatives to feed families, sponsor children's education, and provided support during crises like the COVID-19 pandemic. During the pandemic, Mr. Leos distributed food boxes to over 100 needy families, showcasing his dedication to alleviating hardship. His daughter's involvement in collecting food items underscores the collaborative nature of his work. Furthermore, Mr. Leos organizes events in Cicero, providing not just food, but also clothing sourced from generous donations. He goes above and beyond by arranging nurse visits to check on community members' health, ensuring holistic support. His philosophy, as long as there are people, there will be work to do, reflects his deep understanding of ongoing community challenges. Mr. Leos's tireless efforts, compassion, and unwavering commitment to community service exemplify the qualities deserving of this esteemed recognition. For having performed a long and meritorious service in the field of community service, Pastor Dr. Andrew Leos is awarded the Saint Lucia Lepitor Medal Gold.
The Saint Lucia Lepitor Medal Silver. Norman Stephen Edward, for having performed long and meritorious service in the field of education. Mr. Norman Stephen Edwards' career spans 43 years in the teaching profession, primarily focusing on mathematics instruction for students preparing for the Common Entrance Examination. Even after retiring in 2020, he continues to offer his expertise on Saturdays to students from Castries to Choiseul. His dedication to education extends beyond retirement, reflecting his commitment to student success. Aside from teaching, Mr. Edward played a pivotal role in sports development in Fearfor, participating in cricket, football, and volleyball, as well as basketball, at both community and national levels. He also coached volleyball and track and field teams, contributing to the athletic growth of his community. In addition to his involvement in education and sports, Mr. Edward has served in various leadership roles, including chairman of the Fearfor Facilities Management Committee and chairman of the Fearfor North Constituency Council. Currently, he serves as deputy chairman of the St. Jude Board of Directors. Mr. Edwards' philanthropic efforts are noteworthy as he has contributed to housing projects for the less fortunate and regularly distributes hot meals to individuals confined to their homes. His decades-long dedication to education, sports, community leadership, and philanthropy exemplifies his unwavering commitment to serving others. For having performed long and meritorious service in the field of education, Norman Stephen Edward is awarded the St. Lucia Lipitor Medal, Silver. Dwayne Edward, for having performed long and meritorious service in the field of community service. Dwayne Edward is recognized as a community activist, philanthropist, and entrepreneur with a strong commitment to serving others. For over a decade, he has chaired the Disaster Preparedness Committee in Vieux-Fort North, ensuring efficient distribution of supplies during the COVID-19 pandemic to those in need. In addition to his community leadership roles, Mr. Edwards serves as the president of the Vieux-Fort North Football League. Beyond his passion for the sport, he generously provides football boots and equipment to aspiring players who may otherwise struggle to afford them. He actively participates in field maintenance to ensure optimal playing conditions. Previously, Mr. Edwards served as a councillor on the Vieux-Fort North Constituency Council from 2012 to 2016. Currently, he unofficially leads the North Veterans Football Team of Vieux-Fort, further demonstrating his dedication to community engagement and sports development. For having performed long and meritorious service in the field of community service, Dwayne Edward is awarded the St. Lucia Lipitor Medal, Silver. Francis George, for having performed long and meritorious service in the field of community development, sports, cricket. Mr. Francis George, affectionately known as T. Francis or Frano, is a revered figure in Soufrière. Growing up in various communities within Soufrière, he gained popularity through his involvement in cricket and football, representing Soufrière Primary in both sports. As a cricketer, he excelled as a wicketkeeper, batsman, and fielder, eventually captaining several teams to victory. Mr. George's coaching prowess became evident as he guided players like Keith Prosper and Wayne Prosper, who went on to represent St. Lucia in cricket. He currently coaches the Soufrière Stampers cricket team, leading them to multiple victories and nurturing talents like Pamela Alfred, who excelled in track and field. In football, Mr. George's skills as a goalkeeper, midfielder, and defender earned him recognition nationally. He played for teams like Ghetto Stars and Glaciers, achieving notable victories. Additionally, he coached and captained teams to success in national competitions. Beyond sports, Mr. George's volunteerism is commendable. He maintained Soufrière's playing fields for over a decade and coached various youth sports, including track and field, netball, and basketball. His leadership extended to committees like the Soufrière Youth and Sports Council, where he served as PRO and trustee. Overall, Mr. George's lifelong dedication to sports and community service makes him a revered figure in Soufrière and a true son of the land. For having performed long and meritorious service in the field of community development, sports, cricket, Mr. Francis George is awarded the St. Lucia Lipitor Medal, Silver.
The St. Lucia Lipitor Medal, Bronze. Gilroy Lamontagne, for having performed long and meritorious service in the promotion of community development, sports, football. Mr. Gilroy Lamontine, also known as Coach Gig, has made significant contributions to football development in Sufre for the last 15 years. Beginning with just 10 footballers, his academy, formerly known as Gig's Soccer Academy, has grown to over 150 players aged 4 to 35. Mr. Lamontine's aim has always been to provide a safe environment for youth, particularly boys at risk, to develop a passion for football and lead healthy lifestyles. His coaching efforts have yielded remarkable results at various levels, from grassroots to national competitions. As the co-founder of the Black Panthers Youth and Sports Club, he led his teams to victories in local and district tournaments. Notably, his players have represented Saint Lucia in CONCACAF competitions and international showcases, securing scholarships at colleges in the United States. Mr. Lamontine's commitment to personal development is evident through his attainment of coaching certifications and his role as an assistant coach at the Sufre Comprehensive Secondary School. Under his guidance, school teams have achieved notable success, with many players from his club contributing to their victories. His leadership has led to historic achievements, such as the Black Panthers senior team's promotion to Division I and victories in prestigious tournaments. Overall, Mr. Gilroy Lamontine's humble and dedicated approach to coaching has positively impacted the lives of countless young athletes and has elevated the standard of football in St. Lucia. For having performed long and meritorious service in the promotion of community development, sports, football, Mr. Gilroy Lamontine is awarded the St. Lucia Lepitor Medal Bronze. Angela Sherry, for having performed long and meritorious service in the promotion of public service. Ms. Angela Sherry has served the Embassy of St. Lucia in Washington, D.C., USA for 32 years, making significant contributions to its success. Beginning in 1991, she has held the role of Senior Administrative Attaché, Accounting Officer under five ambassadors. Her tenure showcases her resilience, dedication, and unwavering commitment to the organization. Ms. Sherry's role involves overseeing administrative and accounting affairs, where she consistently maintains high standards. Her impact extends beyond her duties, as she is recognized for her role in the organization's growth. Her exemplary drive, dedication, and performance have earned her praise and recognition, making her a pillar of the embassy's success. For having performed long and meritorious service in the promotion of public service, Ms. Angela Sherry is awarded the St. Lucia Lepitor Medal Bronze. Sonia Rosita Sifley, for having performed long and meritorious service in the promotion of arts. Sonia Rosita Sifley's involvement in the arts began in the early 1970s as a dancer with the Creative and Performing Arts Dance Troupe. She later trained her church club and assisted her mom with her junior carnival band. Sonia's love for carnival led her to become actively involved in various carnival bands, serving as a band representative and eventually becoming vice president of the Carnival Bands Association, CBA, in 2010. 2010. She played a key role in elevating the association's profile and advocating for its recognition within the government. Sonia's leadership continued as she again became president of the CBA in 2013, breaking a male-dominated trend. During her tenure, she organized training seminars, introduced a mass market event, and oversaw the success of junior bands. Additionally, she contributed to cultural activities such as junior Creole celebrations and Independence Day events. Sonia's dedication and contributions to the arts and culture sector have left a lasting impact, making her a deserving candidate for this award. For having performed long and meritorious service in the promotion of the arts, Sonia Rosita Sifley is awarded the Saint Lucia Lepitor Medal Bronze.
The National Service Cross. Superintendent Fabian Kendall Montoot, for rendering loyal and devoted service beneficial to the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, the government, and people of St. Lucia. Superintendent Fabian Montoot has had a distinguished career in the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, rising through the ranks from corporal to superintendent. Throughout his service, he has been stationed in various departments, demonstrating professionalism, leadership, and expertise. His roles have included assignments in the Criminal Investigations Department, Major Crimes Unit, Traffic Department, and more. Superintendent Montoot has been praised for his discipline, knowledge, and commitment to excellence. Notably, he led the first field training officers team, ensuring the effective supervision and training of new recruits. His contributions to operational planning, crime detection, and training have been significant, leading to a decrease in crime in the Central Division during his tenure. Superintendent Montoot has pursued continuous professional development, completing courses in financial investigations, supervisory management, and criminal justice. His dedication to duty and meritorious service over more than three decades have made him a credit to the police force and a valuable asset to St. Lucia's security. For rendering loyal and devoted service beneficial to the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, the government, and people of St. Lucia, Superintendent Fabian Kendall Montoot is awarded the National Service Cross. Acting Superintendent Fitzroy Bailey. For rendering loyal and devoted service beneficial to the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, the government, and people of St. Lucia. Acting Superintendent Fitzroy Bailey has had a notable career spanning over 35 years in the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, ascending from corporal to acting superintendent. Throughout his service, he has been stationed in various departments and stations, including the drug unit, special branch, and several police stations across different divisions. Described as professional, knowledgeable, and committed, Bailey has made positive contributions to operations, general policing, and intelligence. Notably, during his acting tenure as superintendent, he effectively managed the Northern Division, overseeing 10 police stations. Bailey demonstrated strong operational and planning skills, leading 12 major operations in 2021 that resulted in significant achievements, including the recovery of firearms and ammunition. He also played a role in distributing hampers to families in need, showcasing his commitment to community welfare. Bailey has continuously pursued professional development, attending various courses in areas such as officer protection, community policing, and operational planning. With a drive for policing and a focus on accountability, Bailey has left a lasting impact on St. Lucia's security landscape, earning recognition and honor for his dedication and service and contributions. For rendering loyal and devoted service beneficial to the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, the government and people of St. Lucia, Acting Superintendent Fitzroy Bailey is awarded the National Service Cross.
The National Service Medal, Captain Cyril D'Souza Elise. For outstanding and meritorious service to the St. Lucia Cadet Corps, the government and people of St. Lucia. Captain Cyril D'Souza Elise has demonstrated a lifelong commitment to service, beginning with his enlistment in the St. Lucia Cadet Corps in 1985. Throughout his schooling at St. Mary's College, he excelled within the cadet unit, rising through the ranks to eventually become a captain. He completed various training programs, including potential junior officer and potential cadet officer training, where he excelled and was promoted accordingly. In addition to his service in the St. Lucia Cadet Corps, Captain Elise has held leadership positions in the hospitality industry and is skilled as a sound engineer and computer technician. He received his Queen's Commission in 2016 and has served in various capacities within the Cadet Corps, including as a subject head for field craft and public relations officer. Beyond his cadet duties, Captain Elise has demonstrated a deep commitment to community service. He has assisted in disaster relief efforts following storms and hurricanes, both locally and overseas, and provided security during major events such as the Cricket World Cups. During the COVID-19 pandemic, he organized a feeding program and provided security at vaccination venues island-wide, showcasing his dedication to serving others in times of need. Captain Elise's passion for service and leadership exemplify his unwavering commitment to his country and community. For outstanding and meritorious service to the St. Lucia Cadet Corps, the government and the people of St. Lucia, Captain Cyril D'Souza Elise is awarded the National Service Medal. Lieutenant Commander Robert Thomas, for outstanding and meritorious service to the St. Lucia Cadet Corps, the government, and people of St. Lucia. Lieutenant Commander Robert Thomas has dedicated over 37 years of service to the St. Lucia Cadet Corps, beginning his journey at the Corinth Secondary School Cadet Unit in 1984. Throughout his secondary education, he held various ranks within the cadet unit and participated in numerous OECS and Caribbean cadet camps. Thomas's commitment to the SLCC continued into adulthood, where he served in several leadership roles, including Regimental Sergeant Major, RSM, and President of the Sergeant's Mess Committee. He also played key roles, such as Duke of Edinburgh Officer, Training Officer, and Camp Sergeant Major. His involvement with the Duke of Edinburgh program highlights his dedication to personal and leadership development, having completed the bronze, silver, and gold standards of the International Award for Young People. Lieutenant Commander Thomas's expertise in the Duke of Edinburgh program led him to complete leadership courses and receive medals himself. Currently, Lieutenant Commander Thomas oversees the newly formed Sea Cadet Unit within the SLCC and plays a pivotal role in training future cadets. Additionally, he is responsible for training within the National Duke of Edinburgh Award. Major Fitzroy MacDonald Wilson Leon, for outstanding and meritorious service to the St. Lucia Cadet Corps. Major Fitzroy MacDonald Wilson Leo began his journey in the St. Lucia Cadet Corps while attending St. Mary's College in 1979. Excelling academically and earning a scholarship to study building technology, he remained committed to the SLCC, rising through the ranks from private to second lieutenant. Throughout his tenure, Major Leo demonstrated outstanding leadership, participating in various cadet activities and representing St. Lucia at regional cadet camps. He completed the Potential Cadet Officers course in Barbados and received numerous awards and recognitions for his dedication. Promoted to captain in 2012, he served as battalion commander of Battalion 1, contributing to its success and earning the Battalion of the Year award. Major Leo received his Queen's Commission in 2015 and was promoted to major in 2016. Transitioning to Dominica, he continued his service in the Cadet Corps, eventually becoming Deputy Commandant Adjutant. Major Leo's contributions extend beyond the Cadet Corps as he actively participates in the music industry and serves as the Vice President of the Builders and Contractors Association of Dominica. His achievements reflect his unwavering commitment to service and leadership in both St. Lucia and Dominica. For outstanding and meritorious service to the St. Lucia Cadet Corps, the government and people of St. Lucia, Major Fitzroy MacDonald Wilson Leo is awarded the National Service Medal. And finally, in this category, Major Ernesto Kwame Emmanuel. Wow. For outstanding and meritorious service to the St. Lucia Cadet Corps, the government, and people of St. Lucia. Major Ernesto Emmanuel began his journey in the St. Lucia Cadet Corps in 1992 while attending Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. Rising through the ranks from Sergeant to Warrant Officer Class 2, he distinguished himself as a leader, earning respect and cooperation from his peers. Transitioning to the Royal St. Lucia Police Force in 1997, he brought the discipline instilled by the LSCC to his new role. Emmanuel's dedication and passion for service led to his promotion to inspector within the RSLPF, where he is attached to a prestigious department. His leadership roles within the SLCC included camp commander and positions such as fundraising officer and messing officer, and these demonstrated his commitment to the organization. Major Emmanuel served as commanding officer of the 1st Battalion and participated in various high-profile events, including coordinating security for the visit of the Earl and Countess of Wessex in April 2022. His success and professionalism in both the St. Lucia Cadet Corps and the Royal St. Lucia Police Force reflect the values of discipline and service instilled during his cadet days, marking him as an exemplary leader and dedicated servant to his country. For outstanding and meritorious service to the St. Lucia Cadet Corps, the government and people of St. Lucia, Major Ernesto Kwame Emmanuel is awarded the St. Lucia Service Medal.
Another very large dose of inspiration for us to ponder on, to mull over as we continue this wonderful ceremony this afternoon. And at this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce a band I consider top-notch, if we put it in regular palace, in the Caribbean, in the world. It gives me great pleasure to introduce the Royal St. Lucia Police Band as they perform a musical interlude. I'm sure you'd agree with me if I said this police band deserves another round of applause. Thanks. I have been given snippets of history lessons throughout this ceremony. I'm going to give one more, I promise you. And again, I wonder if it's providential that today, being March 17th, a day where in 1905, Albert Einstein completed his theory of quantum theory of light. And we all know that Einstein was a very, very brilliant man. And his theory has confused many over the years, but has also brought much light to the explanation of what happens around us in the world, in the universe. And so you, sons and daughters, who have received such a prestigious award today are in the company, I believe, of Einstein. So good on you. May I now invite Kiba Talium to return to the podium as she proceeds with citations for the Public Services Long Services Medals.
The Public Services Long Service Award, St. Lucia Public Service, Gabriel Joseph. Mr. Gabriel Joseph dedicated 32 years of service as a postman starting in August 1991 within the Department of Finance managing postal services. His roles included overseeing mail operations at various sub-post offices, coordinating timely deliveries, and addressing customer concerns effectively. Concluding his tenure in April 2023, Mr. Joseph reflects gratefully on the experience gained during his illustrious career. His service as a public officer left a lasting impact, demonstrating his self-driven nature and hardworking ethic. Known for his outstanding leadership and unwavering commitment to service, he consistently went above and beyond to assist others, contributing significantly to the development of St. Lucia. Mr. Gabriel Joseph is recognized for the St. Lucia Public Service with the Public Services Long Service Award. Damian Monrose. Mr. Damian Monrose began his public service journey in June 1980 as a supernumerary clerk within the Cooperative Department under the Ministry of Agriculture. Demonstrating exceptional dedication and proficiency, he earned promotions and assumed increasing responsibilities over the years. In October 1996, he rose to Office Assistant 2 within the Ministry of Social Transformation, Culture, and Local Government. Further advancing his career in November 2007, he became a Redress Officer 1 within the Ministry of Commerce, Investment, and Consumer Affairs, eventually attaining the position of Information Assistant 1 due to his commitment to excellence. Mr. Damian Monrose is awarded the Public Services Long Service Award.
Saint Lucia Teaching Service, Simone Saint Fort. Mrs. Simone Saint Fort embarked on her teaching journey at the age of 15 in 1972 at Larouche's Primary School, later moving to Grandview Senior Primary in 1989. She served as vice principal and principal from 1993 to 1996. She earned a diploma in social studies and later obtained a bachelor's degree in education administration and an MBA. For 44 years, Mrs. Sainford dedicated herself to education, culminating as principal at Olio Combined School until retirement. She served as treasurer of the National Principals Association and received recognition from the Saint Lucia Teachers Union in 2017. Post-retirement, Mrs. Sainfort established the Bridge of Hope Community Foundation, aiming to empower youth to realize their potential. Additionally, she serves as a commissioner on the Teaching Service Commission and actively participates in various community organizations such as the Red Cross, Credit Union, and Church Initiatives. Mrs. Sainfort receives the Public Services Long Service Award. Estelita Rennie. Mrs. Estelita Rennie is a skilled technical and vocational education and training TVET expert with over two decades of experience in Caribbean and international TVET organizations. Beginning her career in 1976, she served as a teacher for architectural drawing and technical drawing at the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School until 1996. Mrs. Rennie then assumed the role of vice principal until 2000, overseeing school administration and discipline. Transitioning to the Ministry of Education, she served as education officer for TVET from 2000 to 2014. Additionally, she contributed to the Caribbean Examinations Council, CXC, from 1982 to 2013 as assistant examiner, examiner, and chief examiner for technical drawing. Her leadership roles include serving as Executive Director of the TVET Council from 2022 to 2023 and the Chairperson of the St. Lucia Council for TVET from 2007 to 2021. Mrs. Renee's commitment extends to regional bodies like CANTA, where she served as a committee member and secretary. Currently, she serves as country support coordinator for the Skills to Access the Green Economy SAGE project. For dedicated service to the St. Lucia Teaching Service, Mrs. Renee receives the Public Services Long Service Award.
The Royal St. Lucia Police Force, retired Assistant Commissioner of Police, George Nicholas. Assistant Commissioner of Police George Nicholas joined the Royal St. Lucia Police Force in 1989, serving across various stations and departments over his three-decade tenure. Known for his affability, teamwork, and sportsmanship, he excelled in roles spanning general policing, criminal investigations, training, crime management, and operations. Throughout his career, Nicholas pursued continuous professional development, undertaking courses in areas like emotional intelligence, training, and management studies. He also earned an associate's degree in business management and a Bachelor of Science degree in management studies from the University of the West Indies. Nicholas steadily climbed the ranks, achieving promotions from corporal to assistant commissioner. With over 35 years of dedicated service to St. Lucia security, his expertise, leadership, and commitment have left a lasting impact on law enforcement in the country. For dedicated service to the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, retired Assistant Commissioner George Nicholas receives the Public Services Long Service Award. Thank you. Sergeant John Louis. Sergeant 111 John Louis enlisted in the Royal St. Lucia Police Band in 1986, demonstrating consistency, discipline, and self-confidence throughout his 38-year tenure. Described as dependable, motivated, and skilled, he served as the band's librarian, ensuring smooth operations by managing music issuance and repairs. He became a corporal in 2021, a sergeant in 2022, and culminated his service to the force as acting inspector in 2023. Beyond his musical duties, Sergeant 111 Louis contributed positively to beat and patrol areas, conducting patrols and assisting with security during events like Carnival and the Cricket World Cup. During the COVID-19 pandemic, he valiantly served at a quarantine site, enforcing protocol alongside frontline staff. Despite challenges, Sergeant 111 Louis remained dedicated to his musical duties, demonstrating strong leadership and time management skills. His influence, support, and experience over close to four decades of service to the Royal St. Lucia Police Band are invaluable and worthy of recognition and honor. For dedicated service to the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, Sergeant John Louis receives the Public Services Long Service Award.
Sergeant Louis is getting a very special salute from the police band. And at this time, we move from one heavyweight in musical prowess in St. Lucia to another one, one that has performed within the walls of the White House. What would such an auspicious occasion like this be without Ronald Boo Hingson? Let us invite Ronald Boo Hingson to perform this afternoon. such a fabulous piece there. Boo's fingers have such an intimate relation with the strings of his guitar. It's just remarkable, and he deserves another round of applause for that. This piece is entitled Chanson Marianne and was composed by Charles Cadet for the play by Roderick Walcott, twin brother of Derek Walcott. And incidentally, on this day in 2017, Derek Walcott passed away. Yes. So it's all coming together today in a very interesting way. So we continue now with the next category, the Long Services category, Long Services Medal. And I'll call on Natalie for this purpose.
Saint Lucia Air and Seaports Authority, Ports Police. Port Police Sergeant Kelly Curvin Charles. Kelly Charles has pursued a diverse range of courses and training throughout his career, encompassing topics such as sociology, criminal justice, police organization, management, probation, and project management. He has also completed various certifications and workshops related to quality management, human resource management, leadership, and aviation security. Kelly's accomplishments include acting as inspector at the George F. L. Charles Airport, creating several forms and checklists for security procedures, participating in security tests and inspections, and preparing corrective action plans for aviation security. He is known for his dedication to personnel development, displaying a strong work ethic and striving to make a positive difference in his field through continuous learning and improvement efforts. Kelly's commitment to embracing change and promoting excellence exemplifies his passion for providing meaningful and purposeful security services to colleagues and customers. For long service to the St. Lucia Air and Seaports Authority, Kelly Curvin Charles receives the Public Services Long Service Award. Port Police Sergeant Walter Eli. Walter Eli's career in the Port Police Department spans over three decades, characterized by unwavering dedication and a pursuit of excellence. Since enlisting in 1990, he has demonstrated commitment to safeguarding ports and ensuring asset security. Graduating from the Police Training Academy in 1991, he embarked on a path marked by continuous self-improvement and exemplary leadership, rising to the rank of sergeant. Walter's innovative approach led to pioneering ideas recognized with the organization's Great Idea Award in 2015. He serves as an armorer and an ICAO instructor, emphasizing professionalism and adherence to international standards. Additionally, he shares his expertise as a certified trainer for SASPA. As sergeant of the Southern Division, Walter aims to enhance efficiency and effectiveness by fostering collaboration and innovation, ensuring the Port Police Department remains a leader in security and operational excellence within the ports. For long service to the St. Lucia Air and Seaports Authority, Sergeant Walter Eli receives the Public Services Long Service Award. Thank you.
Saint Lucia Fire and Emergency Services. Retired Deputy Chief Fire Officer George Victrin. During his 35-year tenure, Mr. George Victrin served St. Lucia as a firefighter, rising through the ranks to acting chief officer, and he retired in March 2023. He holds an MBA in Human Resource Management from the Australian Institute of Business, a bachelor's in Management Studies from the University of the West Indies, and a certificate in Emotional Intelligence and Management. Mr. Victrin's leadership was evident during his tenure as Deputy Chief Fire Officer for over 4 years. He provided valuable guidance and support to the St. Lucia Fire Service, demonstrating integrity, honesty, and strong decision-making. Known for his fairness and humility, Mr. Victrin is highly skilled and experienced, contributing significantly to fire service operations and management. For long service to the St. Lucia Fire and Emergency Services, Deputy Chief Fire Officer George Victrin is bestowed with the Public Services Long Service Award. Station Officer Fernando Anastasius James. Mr. Fernando James dedicated 37 years of service to the government of St. Lucia, starting as a pharmacy technician at Victoria Hospital in October 1987. He transitioned to the role of emergency medical technician in 1998 before joining the St. Lucia Fire Service in 2003. During his tenure, he served as sub-officer for 10 years and station officer for 5 years and 7 months, totaling 15 years and 8 months. Mr. James pioneered the implementation of the Emergency Medical Service EMS unit and program within the fire service, enhancing life-saving services nationwide. He significantly improved EMS through training, equipment procurement, and initiating the volunteer EMT program. Mr. James exemplified excellence, dedication, commitment, and a positive attitude, serving as a role model within the fire service and government agencies. For dedicated service to the St. Lucia Fire and Emergency Services, Station Officer Fernando Anastasius James is bestowed with the Public Services Long Service Award.
And we end with the final sector, the St. Lucia Prison Service, Bodley Correctional Facility. Correctional Officer John Monero. Mr. John Monero commenced his career as a prison officer at Her Majesty's Prison in 1997 and steadily progressed through the ranks, reaching the position of Correctional Officer 3 in July 2019. Throughout his tenure, Mr. Monero has completed various training programs, including the RSS Correctional Emergency Response Team Training and Community Disaster Response Team Training. He has consistently demonstrated dedication to national security, undertaking roles such as duty operations manager, where he oversees daily operations and ensures efficiency. Mr. Monero is praised for his reliability, cooperation, and high level of competence, reflecting his passion for service, for serving his country effectively in the correctional system. For more than 25 years of service to the St. Lucia Prison Service, Mr. John, Correctional Officer John Monero, is awarded the Public Service Long Service Award. Correctional Officer Agnellus Chester. Mr. Agnellus Chester has served as a prison or correctional officer for 26 years since joining the public service in 1997. He rose through the ranks, achieving the position of Correctional Officer 3 in July 2019. Throughout his career, he completed various training courses, including close protection, search and rescue, and firearms. Mr. Chester's extensive experience and training have molded him into a confident and well-rounded professional who consistently adheres to public service guidelines. He is described as responsible, disciplined, and mature, displaying leadership qualities by mentoring and supporting his colleagues. Mr. Chester approaches his duties with optimism and dedication, actively addressing challenges and assisting others when necessary. His commitment to serving his country is evident in his exemplary performance and continued dedication to his role in the correctional facility. For 26 years of service to the Saint Lucia Prison Service, Correctional Officer Agnellus Chester is awarded the Public Services Long Service Award.
And it is at this juncture that I would like to take the opportunity here to thank Your Excellency, Acting Governor General, Mr. Errol Charles, for investing the recipients into the Order of St. Lucia. Shall we all give another round of applause to our award recipients today? His Excellency will now be escorted back to his seat. And of course, the Royal St. Lucia Police Band never comes around for one track or one performance. So we are going to have one more performance. It's a tribute from the Royal St. Lucia Police Band. Let us once again show appreciation to the police band. fantastic crescendo there to end. Thank you very much, Royal St. Lucia Police Band. And at this time, I'd like to call on Mr. Auguste Desgazons, Cabinet Secretary, and also Chair of the Independence Committee, to offer closing remarks. Sorry? Yes, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Master of Ceremonies. The Excellencies, Acting Governor General and Mrs. Anisha Charles, Honorable Prime Minister Philip J. Pierre and Miss Marie Felix, President of the Senate, Honorable Alvina Reynolds, Speaker of the House of Assembly, Honorable Claudius Francis, so good to see you, sir. Monsignor Patrick Anthony, Your Excellency, Dame Paulette Louisie, Governor General Emerita, former Prime Minister, Dr. Vaughan Lewis and Lady Lewis, Cabinet Ministers and Members of Parliament, Ambassadors and High Commissioners to St. Lucia and members of the Diplomatic Corps, holders of St. Lucia Cross, Permanent Secretaries, Commissioner of Police, Heads of Public Services and Commissions, Mayors, members of the National Awards Committee, recipients of the 2024 Independence Awards, and their guests, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It is indeed an honor to be here this afternoon for this momentous occasion as we celebrate the strides of individuals who have made and helped to make St. Lucia a mature nation. I take this opportunity on behalf of the government of St. Lucia and the Independence Planning Committee to thank all our citizens and pioneers who have represented St. Lucia successfully in all their endeavors. As St. Lucia celebrates its 45th anniversary of independence, we must be reminded that our success as a country depends on our collective effort, individual strides representing different parts of one body, our fair Helen of the West. Today's ceremony marks the final national event on the calendar of activities under the theme, Devant Ensemble, Building a Nation Through Unity, Resilience and Creativity. The investiture ceremony is a pinnacle moment recognizing a wide range of talents and contributions. It is an opportunity to laud our awardees as we celebrate their achievements. Backup with the technology. When the technology is failing you, you know, you need to have a backup. The investiture ceremony is a pinnacle moment, recognizing a wide range of talents and contributions, as I said earlier. It is an opportunity to laud our awardees as we celebrate their achievements. The recent festive events showcasing multifarious areas of interest and displaying creativity over a wide spectrum of our productive sectors were just a bird's eye view of the contributions of our leaders and stalwarts from the various communities. We took the opportunity at those events to recognize the resilience of persons who have navigated the obstacles faced in the past and even in the modern era. Our achievements began way before February 22, 1979, when St. Lucia embarked on its journey as an independent nation. Whilst we have celebrated numerous wins, we must admit that we have faced many challenges as a nation. Nonetheless, we are truly grateful to our Creator, our citizens, regional and international institutions, and friendly nations who have helped us reach great heights as an independent nation. Together, we can applaud some of our major achievements, including our two Nobel laureates and other brilliant minds contributing to local and global advancement. We can celebrate great achievements in athletics and other sporting disciplines, even world-famous sports personalities. As you heard earlier, Julian Alfred continues to make St. Lucia proud, and we are still basking in the glory of a recent world title. 2 weeks ago on March 2nd, Julian Alfred captured St. Lucia's first ever global gold medal when she won the 60 meters at the 2024 World Athletics Indoor Championships in Glasgow. The establishment of the Youth Economy Agency, the flagship program of our Prime Minister, the Honorable Philip Joseph Pierre, is a brilliant gateway to ensure that young and creative minds gain access to training and funding to ignite their creative and entrepreneurial spirit. In many of this year's independent celebrations, we embraced the creativity of our people in cuisine, pageantry, dance, music, and other cultural performances and art forms that reflect the core of our heritage. We also saw over 140 small and medium-sized resilient businesses showcasing their products, confidently preparing for growth and development in their respective sectors. On our journey of the National Battle Relay, many of our long-standing actors and shakers of our country walked proudly in our communities, satisfied that we have indeed as a nation reached the heights of maturity at 45. Looking towards the future, we see the use of great talents to nation building, a future where we strive towards greater creativity and resilience as we find solutions to challenges, including, but not limited to, implementing mitigation and adaptation strategies to combat the impact of climate change, combating crime and dealing with the root causes, increasing the supply of alternative forms of energy, capturing opportunities in the blue economy while protecting life below water, and tapping into the creative talents to unfold the orange economy. We will continue to face challenges, but as we already know, the greater the obstacles in our path, the more glorious the triumph of opportunities that we will embrace. In closing, it would be remiss of me if I do not recognize and express gratitude to all those who contributed to the success of today's event, and by extension, the Independence 45 celebrations. It is therefore a great pleasure, as the co-chair of the Independence Planning Committee, to first offer thanks to the Almighty for bringing us together for this opportune occasion and bestowing his grace upon us and our beautiful country over the last 45 years of independence. On behalf of the co-chair and members of the Independence Planning Committee, I extend sincere thanks to the Prime Minister and his Cabinet of Ministers for the support rendered to the committee in the administration and execution of the activities for this year's celebration. On behalf of His Excellency, I would like to express gratitude to all those who made today's ceremony possible. Thank you to the National Awards Committee. Reverend Father Dominic Saintud, thank you for doing the invocation. I thank the Chair of Proceedings, Mr. Marcellus Casabon, for a job very well done. To our orators, Mrs. Natalie Jolie Fannis and Ms. Kiba Talium, thank you for your excellent deliveries. Thank you to Mr. Ronald Boo Hingson and Ms. Barbara Kadir, who rendered and provided exceptional music. To the Royal St. Lucia Police Band for their dedicated service and commitment during this event, and by extension, the celebration of our 45th anniversary of independence, I say thank you for always making us proud. We say a big thank you to all our other service providers who supported this event. Events Company of St. Lucia Inc., our official photographer, the production team, Ice Factory, Barbie Limited, our technical team, including the Ministry of Infrastructure, the team from the National Television Station, the medical personnel from the Ministry of Health, St. Lucia Fire Service, the Royal St. Lucia Police Force for Security and Traffic Management, our caterers, bartenders, and of course, on behalf of His Excellency, I thank his dedicated staff at Government House for a job well done. As we bring the celebrations to Independence 45 to a close, let us all give a round of applause to today's awardees for their sterling contributions. For their sterling contributions to our nationhood, igniting our theme for this 45th year, Devant Ensemble, building a nation through unity, resilience, and creativity. Once again, congratulations to all our recipients. Let us celebrate our achievements and illuminate our pathway as we continue striving for excellence. I thank you.
Closing remarks, very well received, Mr. Desgazon. Thank you very much for that. And at this time, we have very special presentations to be made, two very special presentations of a bouquet of flowers. And we call on Ms. Shanadani Shalmine. I truly hope I pronounced the first name correctly. I can go to confession if I made a mistake. That's all right. And so we call on Ms. Shanadani Shalmine to present a bouquet of flowers to Her Excellency, Mrs. Anicia Charles. Round of applause for Mrs. Anicia Charles, Her Excellency. Thank you very much. We also have a bouquet of flowers for the chair of the awards committee, Mrs. Mauricio Thomas Francis. An absolutely tenacious individual, hardworking, very, very meticulous, and that is why this ceremony, I believe, was such a wonderful success. So we congratulate you, Mrs. Mauricio Thomas Francis. Indeed, it has been a pleasure for me to serve as chair of proceedings this afternoon, coming from the town of Sufre. Yes. And as we speak in Sufre, we have Island Champs going on, the inter-secondary school sports. And we have some new Julian Alfreds coming up, and a new Darren Sam is coming up. So we have a lot to look forward to in the coming years for St. Lucia. Peas and beans, yes, that's a good one. That was my brother. Shall we now stand for the national anthem being rendered by the Royal St. Lucia Police Band? Wonderful. Thank you very much, Royal St. Lucia Police Band. And at this time, ladies and gentlemen, we will witness the departure of their excellencies, Mr. Errol Charles, Acting Governor General, and Mrs. Anicia Charles. Please remain standing at this time. followed by the departure of our Prime Minister, the Honorable Philip Joseph Pierre, and Ms. Marie Felix. We'd like to ask our guests here to remain standing as we witness the reception of the award recipients to Government House. Once again, congratulations. And ladies and gentlemen, please be advised that guests are invited to Government House for reception. Thank you very much and get home safely.